Hello, I'm Matthew Buzzi, and I'm here with John Burek, and he has a really interesting device from Intel. It's in the NUC product line, which we've seen many of, bare bones kits, small compact computers, build your own, DIY, anything you can imagine. And Intel has imagined quite large this time. They've imagined big. This is the NUC 11 Extreme Kit, and it comes bare bones, though they did send it to us with a bunch of parts. So John, take it away. I can see it there in front of you. It looks sizable.
Yeah, so what we have here is actually promotional packaging for this PC. If you go and buy one of these, it's not going to come in the giant wooden nuclear warhead packaging that you see here, but Intel sent it to us to get our attention, and it sure did, because the packaging itself feels like about 3 to 4 times what the actual PC does. But anyway, what we have here is the NUC 11 Extreme Kit, pre-configured. I'm going to bring it out of its layer here, flip this
Ark of the Covenant case here.
And slide it open. First, we were trying to figure out how to open it. It turns out it's on a rail. Comes out like so. So let's take it out of the box.
Okay, so it's big-ish, but not as big as this container makes it look.
When you lift it, I mean, the container itself is barely liftable, but this is pretty reasonable. It's still the biggest NUC that we've ever seen. So Intel codenamed this one when they were developing it Beast Canyon, and that's kind of appropriate given that compared to all the other NUCs that we've seen, this is a total beast.
If you're not familiar with the NUCs, and that doesn't seem like a particularly large PC to you, they're usually, you know, this big. They're little box PCs. So yeah. That is quite a departure.
Yeah, the original NUCs were sort of a design initiative by Intel to try and encourage the use of mobile processors in very small desktop PCs. NUC stands for Next Unit of Computing, and they were sort of a look at the future of desktop systems. And as time has gone on, Intel has continued to make the very small NUCs, but the sort of side tangent that the company has taken with the last couple of generations was to also make extreme versions that can take a video card. Typically, the NUCs required the graphics on the CPU to do the graphics acceleration, whereas now you could actually get them with the ability to add a video card. So the previous generation Extreme kit that we looked at was big, but not this big. It was maybe this much, you know, of the case, and it was able to take sort of a short barrel video card, not a full length one, but you can get some short barrel ones there. This, however, will take sort of the full Monty. So what I was going to do is do a quick take apart on it just to show what goes on inside, because there's actually an aspect of this that's very different than any other desktop PC you're going to see out there. So let's go around the back, turn it over here. We take out 4 screws in the back. And while I'm doing that, I'll angle it a little closer to the camera so you can see what's going on here. There's outputs for the video card in here. There's a RTX 3060 inside. But then you'll notice that all the other outputs for this PC are in another zone over here on what looks like another card. And that's exactly what it is. What Intel has done with these Extreme NUCs and change screwdrivers is to use a architecture that it refers to as compute element. And compute element basically is a system on a single board. And the board itself contains the CPU, the CPU cooling, the chipset, and a bunch of other sort of system supporting stuff like the Wi-Fi, mm-hmm. and also M2 slots. So I'm still using the wrong screwdriver, so pardon me a moment.
Hard to talk and open. This sort of adds up to in keeping with the NUC line, a more modular sort of approach to this little PC.
Yep.
Put in quotes.
Yeah, the thing with the compute element is that you'll be able to purchase additional compute elements in the future and conceivably upgrade one of these chassis. So I think it was CES 2019, we saw the debut of one called, I believe it was the NUC 9 Extreme, and multiple case vendors were offering chassis for the NUC 9. So you could get like a Razer version of it or the Intel version. Mm-hmm. And the way that it worked was the internals were the same. It had a sort of a daughter board on the bottom, and then you could plug the compute element card into it. I'll show you how that all works in here. Anyway, taking off the back panel.
That looks much more like a real tower back than the usual NUC offerings.
Oh, totally. Yeah, it's very non-proprietary. Then we take the sides off. So what this is exposing over here is the back of the compute element that we were talking about. So this piece over here is a big card that plugs into a daughter board on the bottom. It'll be clearer once I open up the rest. And that there is the power supply. Turn it around, go off this side. We've got to look now into the innards. So what you're seeing here is the GPU, the RTX 3060 card there. And then if you flip up this on the top here, it took us a few minutes of sort of prying around to figure out how to open this until we noticed that it just says pull over here. And when you pull, it pops up. So I will tilt it a little bit towards the camera for clarity's sake. And then I'll take the video card out so you can see what's going on in there. But basically you've got the GPU here, the main guts of the system, sort of the motherboard and the CPU and the memory all in the compute element over here and the PSU over here. So let me just do a quick bit of surgery over here.
And again, the GPU is in there already, of course, but they sent us components so that we'd be able to see how it worked and be able to use it, you know, with an operating system and components installed. It will be sold though as a bare bones kit, not with parts with it. So, and we don't have pricing at this moment. At the time of recording, it is unclear how much even the bare bones case and kit will run you, but it won't be the price of a full PC because it doesn't have any parts.
Right. Well, that said, though, when you purchase one of these, it'll come with one of the compute elements. There's a Core i5, a Core i7, and a Core i9 version of the compute element. And when you order it at the time of ordering, you get the chassis and then one of the compute elements pre-installed in there. So let me see if I triggered this properly. I don't think I did. So I'm going to do a little bit of inadvisable probing with a screwdriver here.
Got it.
Yeah, to try and just a little lever here to release the video card. And with a proper long-handled screwdriver would be easy with these little ones I got here. Not so much. So you can watch me stumble with the, there it goes, okay.
Yeah, the graphics card, memory, storage, operating system are the things that they gave us for our convenience of testing and hands-on purposes.
Right. So yeah, when you purchase one of these, you can use it out of the box with the existing compute element because it does have integrated graphics. Each of the three CPUs, the Core i9, the Core i7, and the Core i5, do have built-in graphics acceleration. So you can just plug directly into the, I believe it's, give me a moment, HDMI or Thunderbolt 4 ports in the back to power a display directly off the compute element. So you don't necessarily have to have a GPU in here if you don't want to. Although if you're buying something like this and not putting a GPU in it, you're kind of doing it wrong because that's the point of the chassis being this size. So this unit here, this is the compute element that you can see over here. I'll angle it a little closer to the camera to make it a little clearer. But basically what you have here is a really large heat sink on the top here that's ventilating the fan, it's ventilating the CPU. And there's a fan on top of it here that's blowing it out the back. Also, if you flip over the chassis, do a little bit here, there's a hatch on the bottom. And the hatch on the bottom.
What's inside?
What's inside? Absolutely nothing. Actually, there's a slot. If you want to add more storage to the unit, you have the option of three different M2 positions. One of them's under there. So you can add additional M2 SSD storage in there. There's a 500 gig SSD already installed in this, which I believe is on either the backside or underneath the cover on the compute card. I haven't gotten up the courage yet to rip the compute card, or excuse me, the compute element out of the unit yet to see where the other M2s are, but.
And rip is definitely the operative term. That's how you're gonna do it when you do it, is just straight out.
Yeah, actually when this ships, I am not entirely sure if the compute element comes pre-installed on the board or not. So it may literally be like you've got a chassis, you got a card, you got to put the card in there. My thought is it probably does because I'm seeing some kind of delicate connectors going between the compute element and the cooling solution up here. So I'm a little bit sort of hesitant to rip it out on camera here. I'd probably want to take my time.
Take a more careful approach, yeah.
Yeah.
So the size there, it looks big. I know the graphics card was a two fan. Does it look like it can hold a full three fan, or is that sort of the size limit, do you think?
Well, let's see. If we put the card back in, it looks like it's going to butt up against the PSU cables here. So I think you're probably going to be limited to a sort of another short form two fan card over here. But let me just take a quick gander. If I put this back in, let's see what the clearance behind it looks like. Actually, I take it back. No, I think you could get a full length card in here because once you clear these cables,
it'll go right past it.
This is pretty much clear all the way to the front here. So it looks like you could go 11 to 12 inches, and pretty much any card these days is going to be under 12 inches, you know, except you're getting one of the sort of really extreme either you know, three fan extra thick cards, because you couldn't go 2.5 or three slots this way on it. It's strictly two slots this way, but you could do something long and three fan, I believe. Mm-hmm. So I believe that'll be in the specs. I don't have them handy at this moment for GPU fitment, but it looks like you do that nextly. That would probably be the reason this is that length, you know, that you you have the clearance for
a bunch of extra headroom otherwise. What about the power supply? Could it support that? Is it replaceable? Is it what?
I'm looking at it here. I do not have the spec on it, but to me, it looks like an SFX power supply, which would be a industry standard, but don't hold me to that. I can actually take a quick look at it and see if there's any markings on it. But it does look to me like an SFX power supply, which is not a proprietary unit. This is it's a modular. If it's an SFX, it's a modular SFX, because you don't want to have any extra cables hanging around in here that don't have to be. But yeah, I don't see any branding on it. I think I would have to tear off the front to get to that. So we will have a full review of this, and we'll get into the sort of the nitty gritty of the power supply and also the GPU fitment. But at least from this first impression, for taking it out of the box, it looks like you could put a full length video card in there, and you could probably swap out the PSU in case it, you know, went dead or you wanted something higher wattage. But yeah, given that there's a 3060 in there and a Core i9, I think you're probably pretty well equipped.
Probably, yeah, baseline can hold a pretty good amount. And of course, most importantly, I do see, not in this exact shop, but I did see in the promotional materials, that it has RGB.
Oh, of course. Yeah, well, actually, it could.
Most vital inclusion.
Yeah. I mean, while we're chatting here, I could put this back together, and I'm going to need to anyway, and we could get the sort of the RGB going. We did do some photography of this unit earlier, and it was glowing in many colors. So if you would just give me a moment to reassemble it.
Really what anybody comes for, from what I understand.
Yeah, of course. Just remember to put the power supply cable into the video card. Let's see. Shall we screw these things back in? Why not? Let's see. Matt, you can play some hold music while I put a couple of screws in.
Yeah, a little elevator, non-copyrighted elevator music here. Yeah. All right. The full size is about 8 liters. I don't remember if John said that, and it is about 12 long. So, you know, again, bigger than a NUC normally, but it gives you sort of full complement of ports. Again, a Core i9 in something this size. I mean, that was not something that could be dreamed of all that long ago. So,
good point to make is that the i9 that's in here is a. I have it in my notes here. I will take a look and let you know. It's the i9-11900KB. So this is not a mobile processor in here. This is a 65-watt desktop processor. So it's not the full K, I believe, but it is not also the laptop processor. So now the tricky part of this is actually getting the sides and the back on a little bit, because the sides actually look very much the same, and I don't believe there's a left or right on them.
The side panels always more troublesome than they seem to be on any case.
Yeah, this wasn't too bad, actually. It's just you have a 50-50 chance of getting it right, because they look very similar. And then you can also flip them upside down, and they won't fit that way either. But I've done this a few times today, so I'm making it look relatively easy.
You're an expert by now.
Your mileage may vary. There we go.
Pretty simple reconstruction there while you were chatting.
Yeah, and the finish on this is really nice. It's plastic, the framework here, but it has this sort of carbon fiber glossy finish on the end cap here and on this end over here. It looks very slick in person. And in keeping with the gigantic hexagon theme, if you look very closely at the finish, it's a hexagonal sort of in textured inlay. Very, very classy looking.
Okay. All right.
Yeah, so I will just, I'll leave those two screws out for the moment, and got to get the RGB fired up.
Again, most importantly.
Yes. So let's see, I'll get the giant box open here. Let's see. And not many accessories here. It's basically a flash drive containing what I assume are drivers. I haven't dug into them yet, and power cable. That's about it. So. Let's get the there.
Close the case. Light it up.
All right. Okay. Let's fire it up and see it glow.
Oh, ooh. It's there. Got some underbelly lighting as well.
Yeah, ground effects going on here. All right. I'll stand aside and just let
go. Show it off.
And there's also there was actually before a glowing skull in the front. Let's see.
Yeah, it's there.
There it goes. Okay, skull was sort of fading in and out, but there we go. So there we have it. It's the NUC 11 Extreme Kit. We will be doing a full review on PCMag.com with performance testing with the parts that were provided for it. But as mentioned, you'll be able to buy this as a standalone sort of bare bones unit that you customize to your liking, along with the compute element card of your choice. So yeah, stay tuned, and we are testing it furiously as we speak. Matt, any final words?
No, I think it looks neat. The power capability is bigger than maybe what we're used to in a NUC. I don't know if everyone wants a skull necessarily now that the RGB is on the front of their system. Maybe toggleable, of course. But yeah, no, I think it all depends on what parts you get, what you're kind of looking for, and yeah, what you actually intend to do with this thing. But options are good. We love scalability. More room in a build is always good. And hard to beat that compact form factor. Again, as John said, tune in for a full review in the future. As you can see, John is on the workbench with it now. So yeah, we will get back to you with testing and performance and sort of how easy the accessibility and everything like that is. So thank you so much for watching, and stay tuned.